In this example, we're going to ask the user for 5 numbers, and then we're going to total that up. So again, we need to set up our loop first. So we're going to use C this time for a counter, just to show we don't have to call our counter count. So int C, we're going to initialize that to 0. So that's where we start. We're going to stop the counter when we get to 5. So it will go through 5 times, 0 through 4. And then our count statement at the end is going to be C equals C plus 1, or increment it by 1. So we're going to get there by 1. So we set up our loop. Inside the loop, we need our input statement. So we ask the user for a number, and then we get that input from the keyboard. So C and number. Now this statement we added in, this is called an accumulator. This is going to keep a running total as we go through. Each time they input a number, it's going to add it to the old number. Okay, so it's very important we initialize our accumulator. In this case, it's called sum. We initialize it to 0. Okay, and we should actually probably put 0.0 since we call it a double. But 0 is the important thing, so it's going to be 0 because the first time through the loop, whatever number they give us, 0 will be a number that we can add to whatever number they give us, and it won't affect that the total outcome in the end. In other words, it won't add anything in. So we initialize our accumulator to 0. So we take the first time through 0 plus whatever number they get us, and we reassign that to sum. So we have the total so far, which is just the first number. The next time through the loop, sum will contain the first number, number will contain the next number they give us. And so we're going to add the two numbers together and get a grand total. And we'll do that each time through the loop. That's why we call it an accumulator, okay, or a partial sum. It adds it as we go. So then in the end, all we really need to do is say the total sum is, and we output sum, the accumulator, and that gives us the total of all 5 numbers. Okay. The other thing we can do, since we have a sum, I went ahead and added one other step in here. We're going to take the average. So the average is just the sum divided by, so the total number divided by the count, okay, or how many we had. Now we want this C to be 5 in the end. Now I could put 5 here, and the reason I won't do that is because I may change my mind later and say, you know what, I want this loop to do 15 instead of 5. In that case, I have to remember to change it in both places. Not so if I would just put C here. Okay, so C will adapt to whatever I put in this loop control variable. So easier maintenance. Okay, so I'll change that back to 5. Divided by C, remember we said, why do we start at 0? Because it's going to go 0 through 4 in here. But when I do my division here, sum divided by the C, or the count, will be 5. Okay, so we'll get the correct average. And then all we have to do after we calculate the average is C out that average. So let's try this out. We'll compile it and run it. And we'll put in 5 easy test numbers here. Something easy we can calculate in our head. And the total of the numbers is 15, and the average is 3. Okay. I hope this example was helpful to you.